Welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. Spring training baseball coming your way. It's the New York Yankees taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. Just about ready to go. And starting on the mound for the Rays, Zach Eflin.
He really relies on working down in the zone with that heavy sinker he's got. You know, it's not as popular to throw that pitch today as it used to be because, you know, guys are looking to hit balls down in the zone, get them up in the air. It's very important for him when facing same side hitters to be able to get it in, especially early in the count, and to opposite guys be able to throw it at that front hip and run it over the inside corner.
Check swing, but he went too far, and it's 1-2. Bounce to the left side. Over to Diaz. One out in the top of the first. Here's Gleyber Torres. Torres, a guy the Yankees acquired for Aroldis Chapman back in 2016.
He is fearless. You can't tell if he's been in this league for 8 years or 2 years.
Another 1-2. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Around first, heading for two. And that's a two-bagger.
All over that one right there. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Here is Aaron Judge. 2-2 now. Next offering popped in the air, right field. Judge out on the play. Two down. Juan Soto now. And here comes. And yeah, that's downstairs and outside. Check swing, no appeal. That's hard hit on the line. And that will end the inning. The Yanks leave one, half inning complete. We've got no score. Back here at the ballpark, now the starting pitcher in this one, Nestor Cortes Jr.
It's always interesting to see how he utilizes all of his pitches and how many of those he has a good feel for on that given day. When he's right, he's really able to keep hitters guessing, and all of his stuff seems to be coming out of the same arm slot, the same tunnel, and that can make life very difficult on his opponents.
And stepping in for the Rays, Josh Lowe. And a ball evens the count. Struck him out looking. And now it's Ahmed Rosario. That's off the mark. Two balls and a strike. And a swing and a miss there. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. One down, base is empty.
Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Good battle here, about to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. Hacks and misses, it's a strikeout.
Well, anytime you can punch out the top two guys in a lineup to start an inning, got to be feeling pretty good out there on the mound, because when you think of just having a distraction, table setters on the base paths, and all of a sudden you're dealing with the number three hitter, any distraction can cause you to serve up a cookie, and instead of it being a solo shot, it's a two or three run homer.
Diaz tries to hold up, appeal to first. No swing, says Freddie Ferguson. And now the lefty fouls one away, and now 3-2.
Looks really sharp at the start of this one. This is how it's going to be today. It's going to be a tough one for this lineup.
Got him. Strikes out the side to begin the game. What a start.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikeouts. That's electric stuff out there on the mound.
Second inning set to go. Stepping in, the long ball threat, Giancarlo Stanton. Stanton, a guy capable of hitting it a long way.
Oh, you can tell how comfortable he is. Look at that front foot on the line as he is close to the plate. But he can be very quick to a pitch that is down and in.
And he deals. Waves at the bender for the strikeout.
Back-to-back curveballs and back-to-back whiffs. And I tell you what, that's having a feel for what you can beat a hitter with. And clearly, he wasn't picking up that breaking ball at all.
And that's in the dirt. 2-1. The next pitch misses. Now 3-1. Right-hander kicks, deals. And there's a curve through for a strike.
3-1 count, saying to himself, I've got to get a fastball here. Just spins a get-me-over breaking ball to bring the count full.
And that one hit to first. Oh, wow. Nice play. Nicely done for the out.
Look at the big guy getting down and dirty, robbing what probably would have been a double if it gets by him. You love to see that, because most times it's the shortstop or second baseman, but he wants to get in the mix a little bit as well.
The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is, if you are the offensive side of it.
And a payoff pitch. Hit hard. That gets through. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
Pretty tough for the infielders to do anything with that one. He pulled it hard into the outfield, and even when you keep it on the ground, it feels great when you hit a missile like that.
And now Anthony Volpe. They take the force out, and that is that. So they strand a pair. We go to the bottom of inning number two. We're tied, nothing, nothing. We head to the bottom of the second. Isaac Paredes now. The 2-1. Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two. Next pitch misses, and it's 3-2.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Harold Ramirez at the dish. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. On the ground, right side. And it gets by him. Now it's Randy Arozarena. Just off the outside edge.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
And foul ball. The pitch. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. First and second here, no outs. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
You usually are going to see that inside fastball a little longer coming in from the opposite side, but that pitch really got in on him right there. I mean, that's a well-thrown pitch. Tough to do anything with that in terms of getting the hands through and the sweet spot of the bat to the baseball. The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for...
And a swing and a miss. That's out number two.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
That one in for a strike, 2-2. First and second, two down. Next offering misses. Full count now. Rene Pinto up next for the Rays. And they're all loaded up.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boog. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
And now, Rene Pinto. Bounce back to the mound. They get the force out to escape a bases-loaded jam unscathed. And the Rays leave them loaded. We'll move to the third with no score. On to the third inning. Here's Alex Verdugo. Left-hand hitter waits. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Righty delivers. Just missed.
Looks like he's being a little cautious with him in this at bat after doubling the first time up. Doesn't want to make another mistake.
He's going.
Runner on the go. That one is absolutely belted. That's back there. And out of here. A two-run shot, and they take the lead. It's 2-0.
That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
Now it's Aaron Judge up to the plate. 0-for-1 with a flyout. On the ground. Over to Diaz. And that's the first out. Nice recovery after giving up the homer.
It's a good recovery, though, after giving up the home run. Not allowing it to stay in the head, but going to work at the next hitter, and a tough one at that.
Here's a 1-1.
Ball, that's in.
Just off the outside part of the plate. He swings and fouls one off. Still only one out here in the inning. Stays alive. And there's ball four.
Thank you, mate.
Well, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
And a pitch. And 1-2.
Two strikes to a guy who's already 0-for-1 with the punch out. The only guy in the lineup with that strikeout, but you can't get too relaxed. You still got to make good pitches to get him out.
Pitch misses, and the count is 2-2.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there like he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
up the middle. Oh, look at the stop. Rosario to second. What a double play that was. Inning over. But two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this two-run homer. It's now a 2-0 ball game. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And the batter now, Josh Lowe. The 1-1 is fouled off.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
On the ground, out to short. Not in time, he legs it out.
Well, that's one of those where you just have to tip your cap because he couldn't have played that one any better. Stood no chance with the speed running down the line.
Step off throw to first, and he's back in safely. Now here is Ahmed Rosario. Next one misses, and that's ball two. Upstairs. Chris with that distraction and the speedy guy at first. He's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
3-2 now. Battling here as he fouls it away. Here comes a pitch. And ball four, two aboard.
Well, now he's got two runners on after that walk, and things can get out of hand in a hurry in these situations, so he's going to have to find a way to get back into the strike zone.
Yandy Diaz now. Hard ground ball, base knock. Runner around third. Here's the throw to the plate, and he's in there. A run comes in the play.
Big RBI for him right there. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield.
On the ground to third, might be two. Over to Torres. Not in time at first. It's a fielder's choice.
Good late bite on that slider. Got the hitter out in front, rolled over on it. Exactly what he was supposed to do.
To the plate now for the Rays is the DH, Harold Ramirez. Strike two.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. Rosario at third, Paredes over at first with one away. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Kicks and deals. And there's a base hit. In comes the run from third. We are tied at two.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch run scoring at bat.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. And now it's going to be Randy or Rosarena. Three-one, and he couldn't come up with it.
Now that sets up a really big at bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
So now 1-2.
Very well executed changeup right there. If he can command the fastball consistently, that's going to be an important pitch in terms of him turning this outing around.
Fly ball down the line. Soto going back. Back some more. Snags it on the run. Runners tag up from second and third. He'll score on the sac fly. 3-2. They take the lead. Man, is he fast.
That is so fun to watch.
Here's the second baseman, Richie Palacios. He reached out a walk his first time. That misses. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. That one missed.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Rene Pinto waiting for a turn at the plate. Left-hand batter waits. Gets a piece and stays alive. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Two outs, and he walked him.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, Boog.
And now the catcher comes up to hit. Rene Pinto. Gonna count 1-2. Double-barreled action in the bullpen. Luis Gil getting loose out there for Aaron Boone. Weaver warming up as well. Chopped on the ground. To the plate for the force. Out with room to spare, and that's the inning. So they get three runs in the inning, but they also leave the bases loaded. Three innings complete. Rays 3 and the Yankees 2. Welcome back, and now on the mound to start the fourth, Shane McClanahan.
Bringing in the lefty with a left-handed hitter coming up to hit. Classic bullpen move right here, so we'll see how it works out.
The wind and the pitch. Strike two.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
And a pitch. And there's a ball. And a pitch. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate. Got him swinging.
Well, one of the things that hitters will do is they'll look for that red dot on the baseball as it's coming in to let them know what the pitch is. And if they see the red dot, it's typically a slider. But when a guy's got a really tight one with high spin rates, very difficult to determine. And that's probably why we saw a swing and miss right there. Just a nasty pitch.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Getting a little frustrated with the strike zone.
On strikes. Not sure about that call. Pitcher might have gotten a friendly strike three.
Well, interesting. He's looking very comfortable out of the stretch after giving up the leadoff single. Back-to-back strikeouts, so they haven't been able to move that runner up, get him into scoring position, and try to have a better chance of scoring. I tell you, good job so far on the mound. He just needs one more out.
That's to third, and he picks it up in foul territory. Wells, the runner at first with two gone. And a swing and a miss. And the inning is over. One left for the Yankees, and it's still a 3-2 ball game. Righty reliever out of the pen, Garrett Cole.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep them within striking distance.
The pitch. That one fouled off, 2-2.
Well, these Rays showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. The numbers kind of speak for themselves with the four walks. They've done a great job of not trying to do too much and just staying disciplined.
Swing and a miss, and he got him. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. So digging in, Ahmed Rosario. And now two balls and a strike.
I love that Gerrit Cole is sort of a throwback guy out there on the mound, sort of that classic power pitcher. He's going to attack with that fastball, move it all around the edges of the zone, and when he has to, fill up the strike zone with confidence that hitters can't touch it.
The wind of the pitch. Caught him looking for the K.
Frustrating end to the at-bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
2-2 now. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. The big righty strikes out the side. Nothing doing for Tampa, but they still lead it 3-2. We're back, and there's a new arm on the mound to start the fifth. Zach Littell.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
That misses, and a count 2-1. Fouled off to the right. The pitch. Swing at a ball lifted to center field. Brings it in with a nice running grab. And there's one down.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit. And then from there can really settle in.
Right-handed reliever. Swing and a miss. And it's 3-2. Tampa Bay's bullpen with some action. Number 19, warming up for manager Kevin Cash. Bradley getting loose as well. Got him looking. Two gone. It's Aaron Judge now. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
The pitch. And Judge spoils that one. For Judge, he's really developed into more than just a power hitter. He covers the plate well, shows impressive. A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that'll do it. 1-2-3, go the Yankees. They trail it 3-2. Pitching change here, Luis Gil.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
And welcome back. John Schaube with my buddy Chris Singleton. It's set to get us started. Bottom five, Isaac Paredes. Volpe throws it to first in time. And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth. And now the DH, Harold Ramirez.
Beautiful swing in his last at bat. Opposite field knock.
Righty to the plate. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. And now 2-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Two down.
I'm not sure that was the exact location the pitcher wanted, but it worked. He got the swing and miss, and I'm sure a bit of sigh of relief after seeing that one go through the zone.
Randy Arozarena will hit next. Pitch misses, and that's ball two. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. Gassed it right by him. Down in order go the Rays, but they're up 3-2. We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, number 19.
Still a lot of game left, and this game could go either way. So this is a big opportunity for him to get some important outs and try to help carry this lead into the later innings.
And the right-hander deals. There's a swing and a miss. Bullpen movement for the Rays. Shane Baz warming up for manager Kevin Cash. Adam getting cranked up. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. Had him out front for strike three. Giancarlo Stanton to the plate now.
Ball
a Rosarena. Hauls it in, two away.
Well, those can be pretty fun as an outfielder. Got to put it into his highest gear and go a long way to track that one down. Nothing better than that. You feel like a wide receiver playing football.
Check swing, no appeal, and it's 2-1. Swing and a pop-off in foul ground. Makes the grab on the run. And that's the inning. So they go quietly there. 7-8-9, two up in the home half of the inning. Rays 3 and the Yankees 2. Now on the bump, Luke Weaver. And now it's Jose Siri. Hammer, base hit. And that's going to roll to the wall. Around first and hustling for second. And he greets the new arm from the bullpen with a double.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
And that one is in for a strike.
Well, these Rays really impressing me with the quality of their at-bats in this one. It's been fun getting a chance to see them go to work. They really made that opposing starter work in this one. Ran his pitch count up, and now they've got an opportunity to continue making things difficult on the bullpen.
Popped up to the left, into foul ground.
And no, they haven't broken through in a big way in the runs column, but with the way they're grinding out at-bats, it definitely feels like there's potential for more coming.
In the air, right field. Soto gets under it and makes the grab. Runner tags at second. Not in time. He's safe.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Siri stands at third with one gone in the inning. Next offering is in for a strike. At the belt and fires. Got it by him for the K.
He's really good hitting the baseball the other way, so credit the pitcher for having him out in front of that pitch. Clearly he had him fooled.
Falling behind 2-1. There's a strike.
Well, we call that keyholing. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
And that's a little high. Two outs and one in scoring position. Ground ball right side. Oh, great stop. Throw to first. On the money. Nice play. One left for Tampa, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. Shane Baz gets the ball now. Well, one run game, and here is Anthony Rizzo. Ball to strike. The pitch. And another ball. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Popped up. Rosario in position. Makes the grab, one away.
Well, that was a pitch you got to crush. Unbelievable that he missed it right there. And I'm telling you, he is going to be frustrated with himself until his next at bat.
And and here comes. Fouls one off out of play, back to our left. That one hit to right. Tracks it down for the out. And there's two away. And up next for New York, Anthony Volpe. Looking to get the tying run on base. And a strike in there. Volpe started after it, tried to hold up. Now a look to first, didn't go. Fly ball to right. Lowe has it sized up, and that'll do it. Yanks held in check. They're down 3-2. New arm out of the bullpen, Jimmy Cordero. Now a pinch hitter coming on for the Rays, Brandon Lau. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Way out in front of that inside pitch there, and just exactly the opposite kind of approach that you want with two strikes. You want to let the ball travel. Make sure you recognize it. Try to shorten up so that you can at least put the ball in play. Clearly fooled, but I think even more so, you question the two-strike approach.
Swing and a miss, and it's 1-2. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout.
Chance to strike out the side now. You talk about the benefits, the advantages of relievers who can come in and get the swing and miss, whether it's inherited runners or maybe a little jam that they get into themselves. Knowing that they can miss the bat, tell you what, that's huge and can change the ballgame.
Next offering is in for a strike. Fouls it back with two strikes. Fouls it off, still 1-2. The pitch. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
I think the key is arm action.
Staying in the game on defense, Curtis Meade. He pinch hit last half and now takes over at first. Also into the ball game, Jonathan Aranda. He's the new third baseman. Sean Armstrong will take over here. Now into the ball game on defense, Taylor Walls. He's in at shortstop. So now a pinch hitter, Oscar Gonzalez. Swing and a miss. That's a strikeout. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. Pinch hitter coming on, Oswald Peraza. One out, the base is empty for him. The 2-1. Late on that fastball. And it's filled up. Tampa Bay's bullpen with some action. Pete Fairbanks warming up for manager Kevin Cash. Three and two now. On the ground right side. Dives, but it's off his glove. He decides to hold on to it, and they don't get an out on the play. Now a move being made for a pinch hitter. Franchy Cordero, runner on first with one down for him. Peraza stands at first with one out. Here comes the pitch. Runner breaks for second. There's a ball. Throw, and they got him.
That goes to show you stealing a base is a tough thing to do and far from a sure thing, even with big-time speed. It's not easy to catch him, but that was a great catch and throw, quick, not rushed, and accurate.
And that's ball four.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is, if you are the offensive side of it.
And the Rays, they go to the bullpen. Phil Maton.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
And a pitch. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Not what he wanted to do there, Boog. That keeps this inning alive and gives this offense a good chance to cut into their deficit.
The count 2-1. And a swing and a miss. Two, two now. Got him looking. Inning over. That's a crucial missed opportunity.
Well, this guy competes hard. We see the emotion there. I love it. Great job of getting out of the jam.
So remaining in the game defensively, Oscar Gonzalez. He'll be the new left fielder after entering the game as a pinch hitter. Also entering the game, Franchy Cordero. He'll be patrolling center field. On the mound now, Scott Efros. So coming into the game now on defense, Trent Grisham. He takes over in right. Now a pinch hitter coming on for the Rays, Johnny DeLuca. He comes to the plate in a huge spot in this one. Kicks and fires. And a count 1-2. Righty delivers. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. The next pitch misses, 2-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Very frustrating right there as a speedy potential base runner when with two strikes, you just struggle to put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error, but some way you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
That one's in there, and that is strike two. Here comes a pitch. And a swing and a miss. Back-to-back strikeouts. Here's the center fielder, Jose Siri. The pitch. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. Ground ball, Rizzo picks it up. He steps on the bag. That's the third out. Inning over. New pitcher on here, Pete Fairbanks.
Well, he's the guy they hope to turn to out of the pen to lock down wins. So this game has gone to plan, more or less. Let's see if he can wrap it up here.
Top nine, and it'll get started with a pinch hitter, Connor Cannon. Next offering is fouled back. Blows the high heat past him. That's a strikeout.
Well, that right there is what you want to see out of your closer. Come in and close the door, cancel any hope that that opponent has in making some type of comeback in the ball game. Tell you what, that helps him settle in, and that helps everybody else relax a little bit to get these other two outs.
And 1-2.
Well, so many hard throwing relievers in the game these days, you would think that guys have made the adjustment, but I don't know if you ever get used to it. Just pumping gas out of the bullpen, so hard to play catch up.
Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. Got him. Yankees with only one out remaining.
This is definitely what a team likes to see out of their closer. Come in and just destroy all hope. First two batters, two strikeouts. See if he can strike out the side.
Two down, nobody on. That's a strike. Now 3-2.
And boy, that was the pitch. 3-1, you want to be really aggressive on the fastball.
He caught it behind his back. And what a play. Ball game.
Well, this was a tightly played game. Got a little of everything. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching and defense in certain spots. Definitely a fun one to watch.